Many people are collectors, and we always hear about coin collecting. But did you know there are some interesting things that you can do with coins these days? And I'm talking about jewelry. And that's where our coastal expert comes in. Joining me now is Craig Burgess of ANC Gold and Diamonds. Hey, Craig, it's great to see you again.
Hi, Natalie. Always a pleasure.
So now you get into coin collecting. You've been collecting coins for quite some time.
I have since 1964.
64?
My dad got me interested. I was 8 years old, and so it was quickly turned into a passion.
What do you think the intrigue is where you think of coins and people wanting to collect them? What's the intrigue with coin collecting?
For me, it's history, you know, because coins encapsulates the society, you know, our belief systems. It also tells the story of the civilizations. If you look at Roman coins, for example, you know, you can easily see their belief systems. You can also imagine, you know, a person carrying those coins 2,000 years ago, or the Greek coins, you know, with the Olympic wrestlers on them. You know, it's just a phenomenal way to learn, and also gives you a healthy appreciation for the people that have gone before us.
Now, do you have a unique story that you can tell with the coins that you've collected so far?
Oh, goodness, sure. I mean, there was a small collection that I put together of Greek Olympic coins.
Oh, wow.
Now,
if
you think about it, a lot of the, and I'm calling them Greek societies loosely because they weren't necessarily totally Greek, but in that region, they had events, and it wasn't just the Olympics. They had other events as well. But anyway, these coins depict wrestlers, for example, locked up. You know, you can see the study of the body, you know, the muscles and everything. So it's an art form as well. And to think that they were struck maybe 2,300 years ago is incredible. But you remember 1996 when we had the Olympics
here. The Olympic Games here.
I took some of those Olympic coins and made jewelry out of them to commemorate us having a part of the Olympics that we enjoy today.
Well, that's what I was going to ask you, because now we're seeing people that are taking their coins and they're using them in jewelry now. That's turned into a major fashion trend.
That's true, only with my permission though.
Because
there's some coins that you can't use in jewelry. And therefore you need to take something, if you're considering doing this, a family piece or whatever, to an expert, you know, someone that can look for the subtleties that could make it a rarity, and then something you would not want to use in jewelry because then you would hurt the value. But let's just say for coins that tell a story that you're not going to hurt the value necessarily. Those are perfectly good for jewelry. In fact, we have reference right here, one of my favorite designers, family of coin collectors, and made a very famous statement over since probably the mid-60s using ancient coins, using coins with history, using coins that are a bold, beautiful fashion statement. And that to me is the ultimate use, because it's such a beautiful adornment and it tells the story of the civilization, the coin, and gives the wearer something to be proud of.
So, Craig, can you tell me a story where someone has brought you something in and, you know, they didn't even know what they had? Because that's something that you do here.
Sure. I was sitting at my chair, my desk over here, and someone came in and said, "Craig, tell me what you think this is worth." And they turned around and left, or started to leave. And I looked from what I was doing and I recognized the coin immediately, and I knew that it was worth at least $200,000.
Oh my
goodness. So I say I almost fell out of my chair because it took my breath. You don't often see that. I ran after them to give a receipt. And he's like, "Oh, I don't." I said, "No, I need to give you a receipt. And here's the receipt, and let me find out for you." And as it turned out, it was worth more than I anticipated. And that is part of what I do, because finding a buyer for something like that is not terribly easy. However, you know, this is over 50 years. I know a lot of people that enjoy buying coins. They love just collecting, and connecting the buyer and the seller, it makes it good for both. because you've got a person wanting to sell, you got a person potentially wanting to buy. So it works out well for both.
A lot of viewers watching right now, and maybe they have a piece that they want someone to look at. How important is it for them to deal with an expert like ANC Gold and Diamond?
The amount of items that a person needs to see in order to claim that they know a subject, it takes years and years and years and years of experience. So that's my first recommendation. Find someone that's been doing this for a long time, because your brain is like a file cabinet. And so all of these references, you know, when you look at something and you think, oh, I've seen that before, it's this. Obviously, you can Google, obviously there are books, but there's no substitute for experience. Being able to tell a counterfeit, for example, being able to tell a subtlety in a variety, which might make it something that's seemingly common, very valuable, and that happens a lot. So make sure that you take an item to someone that's well-versed and that they've got a lot of experience in what they're doing.
And trust me, if you do that, you want to make sure that you bring it to Craig Burgess. He's our expert here at ANC Gold and Diamonds. Craig, thank you so much for joining us.
It's my pleasure.
Always great to see you.
Thank you. Good to see you too.
If you'd like more information on ANC Gold and Diamonds or any of our coastal experts, just go to our coastal experts page. You'll find that at WSAV.com. Mm-hmm.